is going to bless you.
Dieu va te bénir.
God is a good God.
Deus é bom Deus.
God is a very good God.
Deus é muito bom Deus.
Hallelujah. Amen. So tonight we went, I just want to speak to you.
Essa noite eu quero falar consigo.
For a few minutes.
Por alguns minutos.
And if God gives us the grace.
Deus me dar a graça.
We'll then prophesy in
you. Vamos profetizar.
Yes.
Yes.
Amen. Me and my brother, amen. Don't worry, we prophesy, we cast out demons. It's a family thing, don't worry. It's a family thing. Amen. Amen. So we're going to just preach a bit. We're in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 33. Verse 15, yes. You can read it.
E com mais excelente dos montes antigos, e com mais excelente dos poderes eternos.
Okay. Let's pray. Father, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. We declare your blessing and your favor and your grace and your power to be seen, O God, even in your house. We pray, O God, that in the mighty name of Jesus, ministers speak into our lives tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay. Now, when you read your Bible, and you come into the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 33, I always encourage that to read also Genesis, chapter number 49. Now, when you bring them together, they make more sense. Okay. Tonight, I'm talking about the Ancient of Days. That's what my message is. Now, when you read Genesis 49, we meet the man Jacob. And he begins to speak to his sons. And he says, the sons of Jacob, come to me, I want to bless you. But he then says to them, I want to tell you what is going to come to you in your last days. So which then means he begins to prophesy to them.
Isso significa que começou a profetizar na vida deles.
So he's saying, I want to bless you.
E está dizendo, quero te abençoar.
But at the same time, he's prophesying to them.
Também está profetizar a eles.
Which means a blessing prophesies your future.
O que significa uma bênção profetiza o seu futuro.
So every time.
Toda vez.
There is a blessing in your life.
Tem uma bênção na sua vida.
It's declaring where you are going.
Está profetizar, declarar onde você vai.
It's speaking where you are going to.
Dizer onde você está indo.
The Bible says he then begins to speak to Reuben.
A Bíblia diz que começa a falar com Reuben.
And he says, Reuben.
E diz, Reuben.
You are going to be unstable like water.
Você vai ser imparável como a água.
Because of what you did.
Porque o que você fez.
You are not going to prosper.
Você não vai prosperar.
But then we stop. We then go into the book of Deuteronomy.
Vamos para o livro de Deuteronômio.
Now we meet a man called Moses.
Agora vemos um homem chamado Moisés.
A prophet of God.
Profeta de Deus.
A mighty man of God.
Homem valente de Deus.
He then calls Reuben again.
Ele chama Reuben de novo.
And he says to Reuben this time.
E diz para Reuben desta vez.
Reuben.
Reuben.
You shall live.
Você tem que deixar. Você vai viver.
And let your men not become few.
Seus homens não sejam poucos.
His father cursed him.
O pai dele amaldiçoou.
But comes a spiritual man.
E vem homem espiritual.
Comes a man of authority.
Vem homem de autoridade.
And he begins to reverse a curse.
E começa a reverter a maldição.
We don't know who cursed you.
Não sabemos quem te amaldiçoou.
We don't know who spoke a word against you.
Não sabemos quem.
We don't know who said you cannot have children. We don't know who said you cannot have money. But we know one thing. We have got men of power. We have got men of authority. That can reverse your situation. That can speak into your situation. Whatever has been withheld. for you.
Declaramos sobre você.
In the name of Jesus.
Em nome de Jesus.
In this season.
Este momento.
Your breakthrough is coming.
Tua vitória está vindo.
In this season.
Este tempo.
You will hold your child.
Você vai pegar a sua criança.
In this season.
Este tempo.
You will have your money.
Você vai ter sua criança.
In this season. Things will happen in your life. In the name of Jesus. Verse number 15 of Deuteronomy.
Verso 15 de Deuteronomy.
Moses is speaking and declaring a blessing.
Está falando para declarar uma bênção.
As a man of authority.
Como homem de autoridade.
He's declaring and speaking a blessing.
Está declarar uma bênção.
And as he's speaking a blessing, he comes to Joseph.
E vai para José.
And he says, Joseph, you are blessed.
José, você é abençoado.
But he then goes and he says,
vai e diz,
for the chief things of the ancient mountains.
Pela coisa excelente de monte antigo.
And the precious things.
E com mais excelente dos outros.
These are the things that are going to come to you.
Essas são as coisas que vão vir para você.
These are the things that are going to come to you.
Essas são as coisas que vai vir para você.
Now let me explain a little bit.
Agora deixa eu explicar pouco isso aqui.
Moses introduces something very new.
Moisés introduz uma coisa muito nova.
Which he calls ancient mountains.
Que se chama montes excelentes antigos.
Ancient mountains.
Montes antigos.
Let me explain that a little bit.
Deixa eu explicar isso pouco.
The word ancient.
A palavra excelente.
Means something that is very important and very old.
Significa uma coisa muito importante e antiga.
There is furniture.
Tem mobiliários.
That you get into some people's house. And you look at it and you see this is important. It's been there for the past 70 years. And still it's not broken. It's ancient. It's precious. So it's because it's ancient. So it's important. So ancient things are important. So he introduces this thing called ancient. Now, the Bible mentions 12 things.
A Bíblia menciona 12 coisas.
That it mentions that they are ancient.
Que diz que são relíquias ou antigas.
Number one.
Número um.
You can if you're writing down. It talks about ancient paths or ancient ways.
Fala por caminhos antigos.
So there are ways that do not change.
São há caminhos que não mudam.
There are things that can never be changed.
Há coisas que nunca podem ser mudadas.
We can never replace righteousness.
Nunca podemos tirar substituir a justiça.
Even if we talk about grace,
mesmo se falarmos sobre graça,
we will still talk about righteousness.
Vamos falar da justiça.
There is a kind of spirit.
É tipo de espírito.
That the Bible says goes only by fasting and prayer.
E a Bíblia diz que só sai com oração.
So we cannot change the ancient ways.
Não podemos mudar caminhos.
Fasting and prayer.
Orar e jejuar.
Tithe and offering.
A oferta e dízimo.
You cannot change the ancient ways.
Você não pode mudar caminho.
If you don't tithe,
se você não
der dízimo, a curse will come.
A maldição vai vir.
Whether you like it or not,
você gosta ou não,
it's an ancient way.
É caminho antigo.
We have to walk through that way.
Devemos andar neste
caminho. Whether you believe it or you don't believe
it, você acredita ou não acredita,
it's an ancient way.
É caminho antigo.
We have to walk in that way.
Devemos andar neste caminho.
It can never ever be changed.
Nunca pode ser mudado.
Tithe walks with offering.
Diz manda com oferta.
Prayer works with fasting.
Oração anda com jejum.
These are ancient ways.
Esses são caminhos antigos.
It can never be changed.
Nunca podem ser mudados.
It can never be changed.
Nunca podem ser mudados.
You touch the anointed.
Você pega o ungido.
You die by correction.
Você morre pela correção.
It can never be changed.
Nunca pode ser mudado.
It can never be changed.
Nunca pode ser mudado.
Touch not the my anointed.
Toca meu ungido.
Do not my prophets know how.
Não fazes mal ao meu ungido.
It's an ancient way.
É caminho antigo.
That can never ever be changed.
Nunca pode ser mudado.
So there are things that are set.
Há coisas que são.
They are ancient ways.
Jeremiah 18, verse number 15.
Jeremiah 18:15.
Then the Bible talks about ancient mountains. Now let me explain to you what is a mountain. Whenever the Bible talks about mountains, people used to go to the mountain to look for God. People used to go to the mountains to meet with God. But this was a representation or a shadow of what was to come. When we talk about mountains, we are talking about apostolic fathers like this. These are the mountains. So when you are coming to a church like this, you are coming to a mountain. You are coming to take from a mountain. You are coming to receive from a mountain. You are coming to be in a mountain. Because apostolic fathers, they are mountains that we come to.
Amen.
Somebody hearing me?
Amen.
The ancient rivers.
Antigos rios.
They are rivers.
Rios.
That cannot be changed. Rivers of revelation.
Rios de revelação.
Rivers of revival.
Rios de reavivamento.
We just need to know how to get to the river. Why you come to the church? Is we come to teach you, to teach you how to swim into the river. Because there are places we have been to that we have never been to. There are things that we have experienced that we have never experienced. There are things that we have seen that we have never seen. So we can teach you how to swim in the river. If you want to swim in money, we will teach you how to swim in money. If you want to swim in the anointing, we will teach you how to swim in the anointing. Because there are ancient rivers. I will not be able to preach through all of them. Let me mention some.
Deixa eu mencionar alguns.
So I can get to where I want to get to.
Para chegar onde eu quero chegar.
The Bible talks of ancient times.
A Bíblia diz para tempos antigos.
Isaiah 46, verse number 10.
Isaías 46, versículo 10.
It also talks about what it says, just ancient things.
Fala de coisas antigas.
Should be number 5 or number 6. It talks about ancient men.
Fala sobre homens antigos.
Let me just minister there a little bit.
Deixa ministrar pouco aí.
There are people that you look at and you wonder.
Há pessoas que você olha e admira.
Some of you might be older than the apostle.
Alguns de vocês podem ser velhos do que apóstolo.
But the knowledge and the wisdom that he has got,
a sabedoria e inteligência que ele tem,
you begin to wonder in the number of years that he has been alive.
O número de vida que ele, é a idade que ele tem.
Where did he get this kind of wisdom?
Onde apanhou essa sabedoria?
Amém.
Where? In what time?
Em que tempo? Onde encontrou?
Amém.
In what time?
Em que tempo?
Let me answer you a little bit.
Deixa eu te responder pouco.
The Bible says,
a Bíblia diz,
there shall come a man called John.
Deve vir homem chamado João.
But he shall come with the spirit of Elijah.
Mas deve vir com o espírito de Eliseu, Elias.
What we are seeing is the body of Jonas.
O que nós estamos a ver é o corpo de Jonas.
But what we don't know what is being carried in the body of Jonas is something very old.
Mas nós sabemos o que está a ser carregado dentro de Jonas é uma coisa antiga.
Something that is very old.
É uma coisa antiga.
You are seeing a young man.
Você está vendo jovem.
But in the inside,
mas dentro,
there is something very old.
É algo muito velho.
That's why there is so much wisdom.
Por isso tem muita sabedoria.
That's why there is so much understanding.
Tem muito entendimento.
Because they are ancient men.
Porque há homem antigo.
That are living right now.
Está a viver dentro deles.
And you begin to wonder.
Você começa a admirar.
Where are they getting this knowledge and understanding?
Onde estão a pegar esse entendimento, essa inteligência?
They are ancient men.
São homens antigos.
The bodies of John.
O corpo é de João.
But the spirit is of Elijah.
Mas o espírito é de Elias.
The earth before. He has been on the earth before. He has experienced everything before. There is nothing new to him. What is just new is the body. So they are ancient men that walk among the living.
No meio dos vivos.
The Bible also talks about ancient nations.
A Bíblia fala também de reinos antigos.
It talks about ancient prophets.
Profetas antigos.
Ezekiel 7 verse number 26.
Ezekiel 7 versículo 37.
Ancient wisdom.
E fala para sabedorias antigas.
Wisdom is irreplaceable.
Sabedoria é introcável.
Wisdom can never be changed.
Nunca pode trocar sabedoria.
What the book of Proverbs writes and teaches us can never be changed.
O que o livro de Provérbios nos ensina nunca
pode ser mudado. Be careful of the adulterers.
Cuidado com o adultério.
It's what the Bible says.
O que a Bíblia diz.
That wisdom can never ever be changed.
Aquela sabedoria nunca pode ser mudada.
So wisdom does not change, it's ancient.
Sabedoria nunca pode ser mudada, é antiga.
Whatever it was.
O que era.
It will remain as it was.
Vai continuar como.
It's unchangeable.
É imutável.
So there are things that can never be changed.
Há coisas que nunca podem ser mudadas.
That's why you ought to read the book of Proverbs.
Vai ler o livro de Provérbios.
You have to read it every day.
Você tem que ler todos os dias.
And get wisdom in yourself.
Você conseguir sabedoria.
Because wisdom,
sabedoria,
is knowing how to apply.
É saber como conseguir.
The knowledge.
O entendimento, a sabedoria.
When you apply the knowledge,
você consegue a sabedoria.
You are walking in wisdom.
Você está andar no conhecimento.
We have buried nurses.
Já enterramos enfermeiras.
We have died from HIV.
Que morreram de HIV.
Whilst they teach that HIV kills.
Eles sabem que HIV mata.
We have buried them.
Enterramos.
You get a man with a degree.
Você vê homem com certificado.
In studying the Bible.
Estudar a Bíblia.
But cannot cast out one demon.
Mas não consegue tirar demônio.
Amen. Got a degree.
Mas tem certificado.
Knows the Bible from Genesis to Revelation.
Conhece a Bíblia de Gênesis de Apocalipse.
But when you don't have wisdom, apply what you know.
Você não pode aplicar o que você
sabe. So wisdom is ancient.
Sabedoria é uma coisa antiga.
It can never ever be changed.
Nunca pode ser mudada.
Amen. Can never be changed.
Nunca pode ser mudada.
The Bible then talks.
A Bíblia fala.
About ancient landmarks.
Limites antigos.
The Bible talks about ancient landmarks.
A Bíblia fala de limites antigos.
Now, what ancient landmarks
limites antigos?
Are where people would mark a territory.
Há muito tempo pessoas podiam marcar território.
This territory belongs to the Campbells.
Este território pertence ao Gaines. Aos Campbells.
This territory belongs to the Antonios.
Este território pertence aos Antônios.
So the Antônios cannot go into the territory of the Campbells.
Os Antônios não podem ir ao território dos Campbells.
They need the authority of the Campbells.
Precisam da autoridade dos Campbells para poder pisar o território.
So there are territories marked in the spirit.
Há limites, com limites no espírito.
That's why nobody in your family gets married.
Por isso ninguém na tua família casa.
Because it's a territory that has been marked.
Porque é território que foi marcado.
That nobody from your family shall get to that territory.
Ninguém na tua família consegue chegar àquele território.
There are territories that have been marked.
Há territórios que foram marcados.
That nobody from your family will ever get into an aeroplane.
Ninguém da sua família pega avião.
There are territories that have been marked.
Há territórios que foram marcados.
That nobody in your family will ever have money.
Ninguém na sua família tem dinheiro.
Because it's a territory.
Porque é território.
That is controlled by somebody.
Está sendo controlado por alguém.
It's a territory.
É território.
That is controlled by some people.
Está sendo controlado por algumas pessoas.
But tonight we speak to you.
Nessa noite falamos.
As men of authority.
Homens de autoridade.
That you shall get into those territories.
Deve ir a esses territórios.
Every ancient landmark.
Todos limites.
That has been put into your life.
Colocaram na sua vida.
That you can never drive a car. We declare in the name of Jesus. You shall drive that car. Every ancient landmark. Put it to your life. That says you cannot build a house. We declare in the name of Jesus. You shall build that house. That's why when I heard that you guys are having church here. I was very excited. And my first question was, which church has ever been in this place this long? Because they are ancient territories. That has been broken only by new generation church. Ancient territories in the city. Where everyone who wants to have fun will come here. But us who want to worship God cannot come here. But we have broken an ancient territory. It says to me, we are only going higher. We cannot come from a place like this. My Bible says we move from glory to glory, from one level to another level. So there is a landmark that has been broken by us being here. We declare for your life, you are breaking every territory. You are breaking every landmark. People that say you cannot get married, we declare you get married. That says you cannot have a wedding, we declare you have a wedding. That says you cannot drive a Mercedes-Benz, we declare you drive a Mercedes-Benz. People who say you cannot have money, we declare you have money in the name of Jesus. Two last ancients that I'll tell you.
Duas coisas antigas que eu vou mencionar.
The Bible talks about ancient altars.
A Bíblia diz de altares antigos.
Ezekiel 36, verse number 2.
Ezekiel 36.
Ezekiel 36, verse number 2. When we're talking about ancient altars, 500 years ago, father, who was probably in the bushes of Mozambique,
died,
so that he can get juju, that he might be able to hunt animals and just get meat. And he went to a witch doctor. And the witch doctor said, you have to dedicate all the girl children. None of them should get married. If you want this power, to be able to hunt and get animals. And your great-great-great-grandfather met an altar. And right now, why there is no money in your pocket? Why every business you try does not work? There is an ancient altar somewhere in the bush somewhere, where they declared and closed everything over your life. But we stand as men of power, as Moses of this generation, as the Moses of this generation, and we declare for you, let not your men become few. As you come to this mountain, may precious things come into your life. As you come to this mountain, may money come into your pockets. May every evil altar, may every ancient altar be broken in the name of Jesus. May every ancient altar stop speaking over your life. May every ancient altar, may it be broken in the name of
Jesus.
May every ancient altar stop speaking over your life.
Possa parar de falar contra a sua vida.
The reason,
a razão,
some of you,
alguns de vocês,
there is only girls. Everybody in your family give birth to girls.
Toda a gente na sua família nasce mulher.
It's an ancient altar.
É altar antigo.
Because it has been speaking that there should not be any boy child in the family.
Porque falaram para o altar que não pode ter
nenhum homem.
É um altar antigo.
The reason why all girls don't listen, there is an ancient altar speaking.
É um altar antigo a falar.
But tonight every ancient altar shall be broken.
Esta noite todo altar antigo vai ser quebrado.
As long as you are this new generation,
a montanha de centro da nova geração,
everything in you shall become you.
Tudo que está em você possa
there is going to be a new generation.
Vai ser uma nova geração.
That is starting with you.
Vai começar com você.
That does not struggle for money.
Não struggle pelo dinheiro.
Does not struggle for a job.
Não tem problema de.
Does not struggle to get married.
Não há trabalho para se casar.
Does not struggle to start a house.
Não há trabalho para construir uma casa.
Does not struggle to build a house.
Não há trabalho para construir uma casa.
A new generation.
Uma nova geração.
Because you came to this mountain.
Você veio para esta montanha.
Everything in your life.
Tudo na sua vida.
Is going to change.
Vai começar a mudar.
Every ancient mountain.
Todos os altares antigos.
Every ancient altar.
Todos os altares antigos.
Speaking against you.
Falar contra você.
Tonight in the name of Jesus.
Em nome de Jesus.
It is broken to every ancient altar saying you cannot make it. Tonight is broken in the name of Jesus. Every ancient altar say you cannot go far. Tonight is broken in the name of Jesus. Every ancient altar. Every ancient altar. Every ancient altar. In the name of
Jesus.
Daniel in the book of Daniel chapter number 7.
Daniel no livro do
7.
Daniel 7.
Verse number 9.
Verse 9.
Verse number 13.
Verse 13.
And verse number 22.
Verso 22.
He introduces something new.
Introduz uma coisa nova.
That we have never heard anywhere in the world.
Ouvimos em lugares da terra.
He says that I saw.
Diz, depois vi
the ancient of days.
Ao anciãos do dias.
They might be ancient altars.
Pode ser altares antigos.
But they were created in some days.
Mas foram criados em alguns dias.
They might be ancient landmarks.
Pode ter limites antigos.
But they were created in some days.
Foram criados em alguns dias.
But he says, I saw someone.
E diz que vi alguém.
He is very old.
É muito velho.
An antique.
E antigo.
He is very old.
Muito velho.
There is nothing as old as him.
Não tem nada velho que ele.
If there is anybody.
E se tem alguém.
Before witches were created.
Antes de feitiços serem criados.
Before witchcraft became witchcraft.
Antes de a feitiçaria ser a feitiçaria.
Before demons became demons.
Antes de demônios serem demônios.
The ancient was already ancient.
Os antigos eram antigos.
Before the beginning was the beginning.
Antes do início ser o início.
There was a man who was there.
Um homem que estava lá.
He is called the ancient of days.
É chamado o ancião de antigo.
Jehovah El Shaddai.
El Shaddai.
Jehovah
El Kippur.
Jehovah the Almighty.
Jehovah God.
He says, I saw the ancient of days. Before time was time.
Antes que o tempo fosse o tempo.
He was already there.
Ele já estava lá.
So he is not surprised today.
Não está surpreso hoje.
By people who have gone to a witch doctor.
Só vão para a curandeira.
He is not surprised today.
Não está surpreso hoje.
By people who are doing what they are doing in your life.
Ele já está fazendo o que
but what we know.
Mas o que sabemos.
He is above everything.
Ele é capaz de tudo.
What we know.
O que sabemos.
He is older than everything that is old.
É velho do que tudo que é velho.
What we know. His wisdom is more than the wisdom of the witch doctor. Because he's the ancient of days. There is an ancient of days. There is an ancient of days. He is removing you from your situation. He is changing your situation. He is changing your story. He is changing your life. He is changing everything. Wherever things have been hurt. The ancient of days. The ancient of days.
de dias.
The ancient of days. He's changing your life. He's older than everything.
Ele é mais velho que todos.
He's older than witchcraft.
Ele é mais velho do que a feitiçaria.
He's older than witchcraft.
Ele é mais velho do que a feitiçaria.
The ancient of days. He's older than ancient altars.
Ele é mais velho do que altares antigos.
He's older than ancient limits.
Ele é mais velho do que limites antigos.
Whatever is old.
Qualquer coisa seja velho.
He can change it.
Ele pode mudar.
He's the ancient of days.
Ele é ancião de dias.
His name is Jehovah.
Ele é Jeová.
His name is Jesus.
Ele é Jesus.
His name is Jesus.
Ele é Jesus.
Before the beginning was there.
Antes do início estar lá.
He was already there.
Ele estava no princípio.
Before creation was there.
Antes da criação estar lá.
He was already there.
Ele já estava lá.
And tonight.
E esta noite.
Your life.
A sua vida.
Will never be the same.
Será mais a mesma.
Tonight.
Esta noite.
Your life.
A sua vida.
Will never be the same. There is an ancient of days.
Existe um ancião de dias.
There is an ancient of days.
Existe um ancião de dias.
He's changing your life.
Ele está mudando a sua vida.
He's turning around your life.
Ele está parando ao seu lado.
He's turning around your situation.
Ele está mudando a sua situação.
He's turning around everything.
Ele está mudando a sua situação.
In the name of Jesus.
Em nome de Jesus.
I want you to stand with me.
Quero que você coloque de pé.
And we are going to pray.
Vamos orar.
We are speaking to every ancient altar.
Estamos a falar sobre todo altar antigo.
Every ancient altar.
Todo limite antigo.
There's nothing normal there.
Não tem nada normal aí.
No.
Não tem.
There's nothing normal about you getting.
Não tem nada normal você fazer 40 anos ainda no ainda.
You say, I'll get married in God's time.
Em ser casado no tempo de Deus.
Are you?
Você.
Nothing normal about that. Three miscarriages.
Três abortos.
And you say, ah, it's just happening.
Você diz, ah, só está acontecendo.
Nothing normal about that.
Não há nada normal disso.
They are ancient altars.
Tem altares antigos que estão a falar. Amém.
35 and you have never been to Maputo.
35 anos, não conhece Maputo.
Amém.
Nunca.
Amém.
32 years old, you have never been in an airplane, never.
32 anos, ainda não subiu o avião.
From a chapa to a chopela, that's all.
Só conhece chapa e chopela, terminaste aí.
Amen. Amen.
We normalize things that are not normal.
Nós normalizamos as coisas que não são normais.
Amen.
Monday.
Segunda-feira.
Arroz de bacalhau.
Arroz de pescoço.
Alfa. Tuesday.
Terça-feira.
Arroz de bacalhau.
Arroz de pescoço.
Água.
Água.
Não refresco.
Não refresco nada.
Nothing normal about that.
Não há nada normal aí.
Amém.
Não, aí não tem nada normal aí.
Amém.
Some of the beds that you people sleep on.
Algumas camas que vocês dormem.
If you were that person that Jesus said, I have healed you, get your bed and go.
Se você fosse aquele homem que Jesus disse, te curei, pega a tua cama e vai.
Não.
Você vai dizer, ah, não, Jesus.
Thank you for healing.
Obrigado por me curar.
Mas
essa cama.
Nothing normal about that.
Não tem nada normal aí.
We normalize things that are not normal.
Normalizamos coisas que não são normais.
And we accept things that we are not supposed to accept.
E aceitamos coisas que não devíamos aceitar.
Yeah. It's okay.
Ah, okay.
Up every day.
Seu marido te bate todos os dias.
Nothing normal about that.
Não há nada normal aí, levar por aqui.
Some of you are married today. You know, I was saying to some people that when God created Adam,
quando Deus criou Adão,
the Bible says he was lonely.
Abraão, a Bíblia diz que ele estava sozinho.
So God created animals.
Então Deus criou animais.
And he says, but among them,
mas de todos os animais,
was not found any helper.
Não foi encontrado nenhum ajudante.
And God had to make him sleep.
Então Deus tinha que fazer dormir.
And he removed his rib.
Ele tirou uma costela.
And he created a wife.
Criou uma esposa.
When Adam woke up,
quando Adão acordou,
he says, bone of my bone.
é o osso dos meus ossos.
Flesh of my flesh.
Carne da minha carne.
But some of you,
mas alguns de vocês,
might have taken a lion.
Acho que levaram leão.
Some of you married a dog.
Alguns casaram com cães.
That's why whenever I see something wearing a skirt or a dress.
Por isso quando ver qualquer coisa usar saia ou vestido sempre está assim.
Normal about your husband sleeping with every woman there.
Não há nada normal teu marido andar a dormir com todas as mulheres aí da zona.
Nothing normal.
Não tem nada normal aí.
Amém. Amém.
Let me say, it's okay. No, it's okay.
Ele é homem, sabe?
There are spirits speaking against you.
São espíritos que estão a falar contra você.
Altars that are saying you can never stay in marriage.
São altares que dizem você não pode ficar no casamento.
Altars that are saying you can never enjoy marriage.
Altares que dizem você nunca vai desfrutar um casamento.
You have been married for 12 years and have never enjoyed, not even.
Casou 12 anos, mas nunca também gostou do que.
Amém.
Doze anos casado.
Never enjoyed your marriage.
O seu casamento você também gramar nada. Não tem nada de normal nessa parte.
You get a job.
Você que emprego.
3 months later you get fired.
3 meses depois está sendo tirado.
And you get another one.
Encontra outro emprego.
You get fired again.
Te tiram mais.
And you think it's normal?
Você já é normal. É normal isso?
You have 5 girls in your family.
São 5 meninas da sua família.
All of you have been married and divorced.
Todos casaram, divorciaram, casaram,
divorciaram. You've got a child with this one, another man.
Criança com um pai, criança com outro pai.
All 5 of you.
Todos 5 vocês.
And you think it's not
altar must fall to tonight.
Esse altar tem que cair esta noite.
That altar must fall to tonight.
Esse altar tem que cair esta noite.
So I want you to raise up your voice.
Eu quero que você levante a sua voz.
And I want you to
tell
the ancient altar.
Todo altar antigo.
Tell it you're falling down tonight.
Esse altar
está
a cair.
Tonight you're falling down.
Esta noite está a cair.
Tonight you're falling down.
Esta noite está a cair.
Every ancient altar.
Todo altar antigo.
You're falling down tonight.
Está a cair esta noite.
You will not speak into my life again.
Você não vai falar mais.
Lift up your voice and begin to pray.
Levanta a sua voz e começa a orar.